Yeah.
And when she moved out, things went bad for her. But when she moved back in, things got good again because she was benefiting off of his money, paying half of the bills. You see what I'm saying?
In this particular video right here, I raised the question, how exactly does a man benefit from signing a marital contract? Amongst all the women on the call, only one was actually capable of answering that question, and that was Queen Nyziri. All the other women, they became combative. They say, we feel like you're attacking us, and so on and so forth, from the simple fact of me saying you're not entertaining the question. Sharon Shea would say, well, a woman could do this, a woman could do that, a woman could do that. But she still neglected and failed to answer the question, how does it benefit a man by serving a marital contract, by signing a marital contract? And the fact of the matter is, what I'm trying to teach men and educate men, there is nothing beneficial to you as a man with signing a marital contract. What you're signing up for is to be divorce rate. You're signing up to be betanized. That's what you're signing up for. And any man that goes against this ideology is likely going to end up a victim. There's some terms I'd like you to become familiar with that Khan Tazadaq used. There's something known as ASD, anti-slut defense. This is a technique that women use when they don't want to be referred to as a slut. So a woman could be, and is usually often just intrigued with a man and wants to have sex as much as a man wants to have sex, but ASD kicks in because of the societal norms has persuaded a lot of beta men and women that women having sex is a bad thing. So because of that, a lot of women have actually been indoctrinated by ASD. So lots of times they want to have sex with a man they don't. This is why a lot of women won't have sex on the first night. Sometimes it's culturally based from women like India and other places like the Muslim cultures. So religion could play a factor. But it's anti-slut defense. She doesn't want to be referred to as a slut. The other term I'd like you to become familiar with is PHS. This is a provider hunter status. Many women go into PHS, which is provider hunter status. What do I mean by that? I mean, she's on the hunt looking for a provider. She's in a provider hunter status. And so when she's in provider hunter status, ASD, anti-slut defense, also kicks in because she only wants to have sex with a man that's willing to marry her. So she's on the hunt for a marriage. Because the marriage contract is a unilateral contract. It's one-sided. It always favors the woman. Unless she's a woman of substance. And so, there's another term I'd like men to become familiar with. Because this applies to a lot of men. Men that become a onist. A onist. And what I mean by that is he get totally obsessed with this one woman. There could be other women that's actually interested in him, but this woman might throw the box on him and he become boxed in. He gets boxed. And so the only thing he could think about is this woman. He's constantly chasing her. And sometimes when this man becomes a witness, he doesn't even get the box because she's turned off by him constantly chasing her. His eyes are closed to all other women. Women, he becomes a onist. So watch out for these kind of men. And as I use these terms, you'd be like, oh yeah, I know what he's talking about. And finally, betanize. When a woman initially meets a man, she wants him to be an alpha. She's attracted to an alpha. He's dominant. He's intelligent. He's financially where he should be. He could attract many other women. Women are intrigued by that. But once she gets in a relationship with him, she betanizes him. She said, your rod belongs to me now. You don't deal with anyone else but me. I need you to do this. I need you to do that. And he begins to conform, and he goes from an alpha to a beta. So, back to the initial question. To you, the listening audience, how does it benefit a man? What's the benefit of a man signing a marital contract? Answer that in the comment section. How does it benefit a man signing a marital contract?
The bills. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, she stated that. I was used to paying it all by myself. So, hey, that's what you said. Oh, so it's a financial thing, man.
You about to turn into the psychic Kahan on it. The prophet Kahan.
Wisdom.
I didn't know that. That's amazing.
Yeah, wisdom of him, like a phone book.
Go ahead, baby.
I would call it at the beginning.
Hey, but Queen,
I recall at the beginning. Oh, Salon. Okay.
Now go ahead.
I was going to say, I recall at the beginning, she saying that it was hard with just her and her kids, mm-hmm. even though she was doing it and she was independent. When she went with him, you know, she felt like she was surprised by him putting a requirement of her splitting the bills. You know what I'm saying? Which mm-hmm. to me is kind of weird. Because if you're doing it all by yourself and it's hard and you got such a good job as HR, you taking your HR job and you splitting bills, you know, down the middle enough to where now you have all this financial investment, you got a business, and now you have toys that's deterring you and allowing you to be supposedly disrespected by, you know, by your stepchildren. Mm-hmm. Where are you getting tired of the fifth? Like, why are you tired of the 50-50? Like, I'm confused when you've gained so much. You know what I'm saying? Like, she's gained a business. They have boats, you know, toys and, you know, different things like that. When the initial question that came out had something to do about, you know, what do you believe, you know, is... Do you believe, like, some sort of effect of a high-value man requiring you to pay 50-50?
Yeah, it makes sense.
I'm asking you as men, do you feel that that is sufficient to ask a woman to pay half the bills and the mortgage and still consider yourself to be a high-valued man?
Want me to tell you my mindset?
Yes.
I'm going to pay all my own bills. You know why? So whether you here or not, I'm still rolling.
What you heard tonight?
I heard the woman that said that she was attacked. I just felt that I was really concerned about that because she said that she was attacked, and I didn't feel that she was that he was attacking her in any type of way. I just felt she became emotional and she need to, you know, kind of learn how to accept, you know, she needs to learn how to like critical think. So I took it as she was being very emotional and taking it personal. And I was waiting myself. I was waiting for the question that was never answered.
Right now, that many men that's in the court system right now just wishing that they never signed a marital contract. They
lost have you been
children,
married?
They lost their house. They lost their cars. Damn near everything.
But have you experienced that? Have you
no,
been
I'm
married?
Not that stupid. I'm not that stupid.
Okay.
Well, are any other men on the call married that can perspective add to it?
I would never. I think see, I would be able you guys to can't even respect each other because you keep talking over each other. I ask you to show some decorum. See, it becomes more obvious why you're having these issues in relationships.
Okay.
Because if you can't respect each other right here, you can't do it in the home environment either.
Right.
Giggle. No one can answer the question. Why? Think about that, guys. No one can answer that question.
Every situation is different.
Answer the question, Juan.
You asked the question. There are some happy marriages that are successful.
I'm not talking about any kind of third party intervener.
Tell me what
a man getting legally married. Tell me how. Let me put it more clear, right? Let's say a man is making six figures or more, right? The man's established. He's financially good. Tell me, how is he going to benefit by signing a marital contract in this society? Tell me, how is that going to benefit him? Because I could show you a lot of different ways it's going to benefit the woman.
Well, it could benefit him in many ways.
Answer the question.
If you give me a chance, I will. Yes. He can benefit in many ways of having a life partner with him. She could bring a lot of value to him. He may not need the value, but this is not fair.
You're not answering my question.
Please let me speak.
No, she's not answering the question.
Tazadaq, you promised that this was not going to be like this. Because I could just leave.
Answer the question.
I'm trying to answer the question, but you're acting like this of a jury and you're a lawyer. I am saying that other partner can bring things to the table that is beneficial to that man, although he has a six-figure
income. Name it. See,
he can help.
She
can help further his business. She can assist him.
Need it for that.
He gives him support. But he can't sleep with money. He can't hug his money at night.
Amen.
Listen,
you're not answering the question. You're doing what the typical woman does. You're not answering
your question.
I said that this man was already established. This man is already
financially where he needs to be. What does him being established have to do with emotional support? Companionship.
If you can listen with your emotions attached,
then go ahead and do so. But I am saying
if you can listen with your emotions detached, then maybe you can hear me.
Excuse me.
I'm going to repeat it again.
So it should be apparent where these women are in their 40s and 50s, and they're almost 60s and single. They're tap dancing around the question. She's addressing many other issues. She's telling me all the things that a woman could do and bring to the relationship. But she's yet to answer the question, how is it going to benefit the man by signing a marital contract? Because she knows the answer. It doesn't. That's the correct answer. It doesn't. It's always detrimental for a man of substance to sign a marital contract because he will get divorce rate in the end. And this is why they've avoided and evaded the question. And so look at the disrespect. They're talking over. They're avoiding the questions, but still saying, and Lisa is utterly disrespectful. She's answering the question. I mean, they go to extremes of a lying, capping, everything because the answer would box them in. And so instead of being accountable for admitting that, it's not beneficial to the man, they rather talk around the question. And this is what I need guys to see clearly.
I'm going to repeat it again.
You know what?
The man is already established. He's financially where he needs to be.
It doesn't mean he can't be better. It doesn't mean she can't.
Exactly. He doesn't need you to make him better. Let me tell you what you're doing. You're trying to say that the man can't be better without you, and that's a damn lie. See, this is what we don't want, right? You're trying to come on here and say that you can make the man better. Why in the hell aren't you doing it yourself? That's what
I'm
doing.
Why would a man have a woman anyway then? You should answer your own question. What do you need from a woman that you would want to be by yourself?
You're missing a point because you're too emotional. My point is this.
You are sounding emotional. You can't say
a man does not benefit.
Look at you. You're up in a flare.
A man does not benefit because these women won't be quiet and let me speak.
Okay.
A man cannot benefit.
You definitely are
legally
married. The Trump party
is what I'm saying.
I'm going to get off the call.
A man does not benefit by getting legally married in this system.
So now this lady Sabrina said, I'm going to get off the call as if it's going to hurt me. And this is the same damn thing that she's doing in her marriage. She left the man, and when she found out that it's not going to be as productive to be on her own, he took her back. because he went into beta mode. When a woman leaves, one thing that my father taught me, you never take her back. Don't allow her to come back. If she's been out there, she's been involved with someone else, don't take her back. I'm Kahan Tazadaq, a spokesman for men and women that love them. And this is the real, pure, unadulterated truth. And if I offended you, I meant to.
It always hurts him. That's my point. It always benefits the woman. I'm telling you, Sharon is saying he could benefit many ways. I said that the man is already financially established, right? So he doesn't need you to come in and help him. You could help him, but he doesn't need it. So don't make it seem like I'm going to make him better. He's better because I came in. Because he could get any woman to do that. See, my point is this. If you're going to come in to help him, you could do that without him signing a marital contract, something that's going to hurt him. That's my whole point. The marital contract is going to hurt the man and benefit the woman. There's nothing beneficial whatsoever about a marital contract for a man. Nothing. Now, I challenge you guys to tell me how it's beneficial to him. Because just like she said she could help him, she could help him without being married.
I'm about to leave because, Tazadaq, you do this every time. I don't understand what's the point in having these conversations and discussions if you're not going to allow people to share their different views. Not every marriage got to end up in divorce court.
Yes.
So, like, it's pointless. I mean, why would he want a partner anyway? Why does a woman want a partner? Because, yes, maybe one can make a thing go right, but two can make it go even better.
That's right.
That's what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about somebody that's coming
in. I was just addressing my question.
Just looking, just, excuse me. You asked me a question. She may have ways to grow his business in ways he didn't even never think of before.
Thank you.
What was the question that I asked
you? Most men are most successful because they can grow
and become a better version of himself.
Shay, what was the question that I asked you, Shay?
You asked me what could be beneficial about a man getting married legally in these days and time. But
okay,
just
so
like
how have you answered that?
A woman can be sued too, financially.
How have you answered that?
I did answer that. If you wasn't satisfied with the answer that I gave,
you haven't told me how it's going to benefit him.
Told you how it can benefit him.
No, you're telling me what the woman could do. And I say he could do that without her being married to him. She could do that without being married. What woman
and what man who really say that they're committed to each other don't want to go ahead and make the commitment? Because
okay,
really,
so you tell me how that's going to benefit the man.
Commitment. I just told you how it could benefit
the
man.
No, you don't see the benefit in that.
Because when the girl comes also with her own six-figure income, she does not with him for money. They're together because they complement each other. And it's nice to have somebody by your side.
You haven't told me how him signing a marital contract is going to benefit him.
I just told you how it can benefit.
No, you haven't.
Yes, I have. Because the same way...
You're telling me the things that she could come into the relationship and do. You're not telling me how him signing the contract is going to benefit him.
That's the benefit. It's like a life insurance contract.
She could do that without them being married. How is the marital contract going to benefit the man?
What couple don't go ahead and sign a marriage certificate knowing how the state
intelligent
has set
men
up.
Don't do that.
Excuse me.
Not in this day and age.
And many have done it over a period of time.
And they got burned.
Not every man has Kobe Bryant, not every man has Dr. Dre, not every man has Brad Pitt. They now have contracts and all these other things to put into place to keep it. Women have gotten burnt
as
too.
Kanye
women
West.
Have gotten sued too.
You see my point?
This is
you
not a one-way street. This is
they
not
can't
a
give
street.
One reason, man.
I did give a reason. You don't accept the
no,
reason.
You haven't.
Yes, I have. Yes, I have. She can add to him in ways that his money can't add to him. Just like he asked.
That's not answering my question. Are you not understanding my question?
Excuse me. I understood your question. I'm not a moron.
Okay, so if you understood my question, why are you not telling me how him signing the marital contract is going to benefit him?
He by marrying that woman, they can merge them. It's a business contract like every other business contract. So what's the point
signing
of
the contract?
You haven't answered the question. The question is, how is a man signing a marital contract going to benefit that man? You haven't answered that.
Excuse me, because maybe he can be with that woman if he don't sign something that commits him to that relationship.
So
the point is this: how is it going to benefit him signing a contract?
I just told you how it could benefit him. The same way she can inherit. The same way she can inherit his fortune, he can also inherit her fortune. What happens if she dies? Everything that she has goes to him. She can make medical decisions over his life. He can make medical decisions over her life.
You're not addressing.
That is those are the benefits. Those are the benefits. Those are the benefits. Those are.
Am I missing this? So no, again, Shay, I'm going to ask the question again. Maybe you should tone your emotion down and listen. How does a man signing a marital contract?
How does a man signing a marital contract
benefit that man? You've yet to answer that.
I answered that. You don't like my answer.
Tell me how him signing a marital contract benefited him. That's why you're mentoring money.
Because I see that you stop the love from already perpetuating that. What does a man have to gain? Da, da, da. That's bullshit. If you a real man, you gonna have that money already put aside
Don't give me that little spill.
Why is the man gonna put aside a woman? Whatever way it go, money ran through by four, five, six,
seven men. You've had babies come through your womb. What value are you bringing a man?
Excuse me.
You've already had babies come through your womb.
You sound stupid.
Yeah. So I would like to know what value you're bringing him that you already haven't.
Let the lady speak, please. Miss, can you talk?
Yes, ma'am. This just sounds like an attack.
It just sounds like
we're brought here to be attacked. And personally, I've been sitting back and I've been respectful and I've been listening to this conversation, and it has nothing to do with the topic of the live stream. Mm-hmm. So with that being said, sir, thank you for having me on, but I'm going to go ahead and dismiss myself. You guys have a good night.
Good night.
I pray that men are taking heed here, because these are the same kind of women that would get you locked up and scream rape or something of that nature. Now, this older lady is saying that it seems like an attack. There was not one phrase, not one word uttered that was actually attacking anyone. The only thing that was reiterated, can you answer the question, how does it benefit a man by signing a marital contract? So they go to any extreme besides the focal point, because the question would have boxed them in.
On what you heard tonight.
I heard the woman that said that she was attacked. I just felt that I was really concerned about that, because she said that she was attacked, and I didn't feel that he was attacking her in any type of way. I just felt she became emotional, and she need to, kind of learn how to accept. She needs to learn how to critical think. So I took it as she was being very emotional and taking it personal. And I was waiting myself. I was waiting for the question that was never answered. So I was more concerned about that.
Well, that's a different sister, Lisa. What do you think about that?
Oh, I want her to answer the question that was never answered, because she didn't get a chance to answer it as well, about the marriage, signing a contract.
What was the question? How does it benefit a man, right?
Yeah, the question was very simple, Julio. What I kept asking them, and Sharon said she answered it, right? And then when I was telling her, you haven't answered the question.
He never answered it.
Then Alicia jumped in and said, no, let her talk. I said, no, she never answered the question. What she started doing was telling me the things that a woman could bring to a marriage, right? But the question was, how does it benefit the man by him signing a marital contract? Because he's going to go to court. He's going to get divorce rate. If he is retired, he's going to lose half of his pension. He's going to leave half of his IRA. He's going to lose half of his retirement. So him signing the marital contract causes all of these things. There's only a few states that still have what is known as common law marriages, right? And so if he doesn't get married in the legal system, they can have the same relationship, right? Remember, this is the same woman said that it was built off of love, right? Or she really wanted was love, right? So if that's true, why do you need the marital contract?
Come. So I guess, I'm guessing she wanted you to present that question to Queen Zuri, y'all.
Yeah.
Oh, the Queen Zuri already heard the question. So what you think about that, Queen Zuri, from a different perspective? What's your opinion on that? What does the man benefit from a contractual marriage, like the regular way? You know, the society got it right now.
Well, he doesn't benefit because usually he does get burned for a lot of things, and he loses, because I know it happened to my brother. And so I think he doesn't benefit from it at all.
It happened to my brother. He lost his house.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She took his one of his cars. She wiped out the entire bank account.
Bank account, yeah.
She put a protective order on him that lasted for 6 years off an allegation. Mm-hmm. He didn't see his children, his daughter, for 6 years. And then when he saw one of them, she had already became a lesbian. Because she saw the mom involved with a different woman in the shower. And so I guess she took that spirit. Wow. And so, and now she comes back and say, I want more child support. And he's been paying child support for all of those years, like $2,500 a month in California.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, it's big in California, how the woman benefits from the marriage and the guy usually loses. Because again, like I said, my brother was one of those guys, your brother. So, and that's how it usually happens. I mean, that's how it usually ends.
And now she gets to get half of his retirement. Because she was married to him for 13 years. And guess what? She has a master's degree in education. And even though she was working, that didn't matter. Even though she was making almost $100,000 a year, it really didn't matter. She still get money.
Snow Bunny, right, y'all?
Snow Bunny. Yep, Snow Bunny.
You know what the fact is? This is how I see it. The fact is that Kahan, he dissects his questions. And I believe that the women don't like the questions that he asks, because he's not taking sides, and he wants to see if the female is telling the truth, or you know, if she's lying. And then he does sometimes catches them in, you know, I've seen him catch people in lies many a time. So I just believe that they don't like the way that he dissect his questions. I love the way he dissect his questions, because he can determine whether or not you're lying. And so they get mad at that. And so women tend to run from, they're pretty much running from the question, because they can't answer it truthfully.
Come, okay. And then when they run, the scriptures say the wicked shall flee when no man pursueth. I forget the exact I forget the exact scripture, but it definitely reads that exactly. Mm-hmm. The wicked shall flee when no man pursueth.
Mm-hmm.
Do anybody know the precept? Anybody know that?
I like her because she's dramatic. What you're talking about is Proverbs 28:1.
Come.
She stand on her principle. That's why I keep calling her back. Listen, Lisa. You side with everyone against Kahan Tazadaq. You think I don't hear you?
Okay.
You're like, let her talk. I'm trying to get her to answer the question.
She ain't answering nothing. He's just constantly talking about what they could bring to the table. Oh, they could up his business by times 10 or something, this and that. Like, I heard a little piece of That ain't got nothing to do with what does a man benefit. And I still would love to hear your perspective on that, unless you already went through it and I missed it. You know what I mean? Like, what does a man benefit from marriage? Contractual is that, like, the way how they the government got it set up.
It doesn't have to be contractual. I think it should be based on love.
And now, I'm talking about the exact question, though, the contractual way, like how the government got it set up. How does a man win, or what does a man benefit from that? That was like the original question, right?
I consider myself a part of the men, because I would ask the same question.
Usually if a man's a real man of value, he's going to probably not want that woman to do anything but to look after his children, the house, and help him. Not anything outside of the home. Because if he's really a man of value, if his wife is working outside of the home, that's going to take away the time that he could be with her. Because let's face it, men that makes a certain amount of money don't have a lot of extra time. So the extra time that he has, he's going to want to spend with her. But if he's working, she's not going to be available for that. And so this is why a lot of women that make 100 or some thousand, they're never able to get with that high value man, because she's working just as much as him. So those relationships don't work, which is why a high value man will like, yeah, I'll take that woman from Burger King, because I'm going to be able to get most of her time. And so all I need for her to do is to be in compliance with me, and it'll work out better than the woman that say, oh yeah, I'm working on my career. Really, men of value don't look for that. They don't care about how much she's making, because he's not going to be, he doesn't want that. He's not needing that. What he wants is her time. He wants her time. He wants her to stay attractive, and he wants her to be submissive. Those are the things that's really going to keep a man of stature.
And then what about when, I'm just asking this question because there are so many women now that are making seven figures and have a lot of businesses and different things.
Those women are single.
No, I'm asking you if that is the woman you end up. No,
I would never be with a woman like that. I would never be with a woman like that.
But so you couldn't help to continue build together and get more?
Her life, listen, Lisa, let's look at the, and this is why I was trying to get people to address the questions. Okay, so let's dissect that, right? She's making seven figures, right? Name the kind of job that she would actually have to be making seven figures.
Well, she could be a doctor, a lawyer. She could be an online personality.
Okay, stop. Whoa. Good.
TikTok.
Good. Okay, hold on. Good. If she's a doctor, how many hours does a doctor work a day?
Okay.
Okay, what about a lawyer? The reason that a high value man won't be able to have a good relationship with a lawyer is because a female lawyer has to be masculine and dominant. She's used to telling people what to do. She's going to bring that same thing over into her relationship. She has to take on masculine energy because she's accustomed to telling people what to do, not to mention that she's going to be working long hours. So that's not going to work.
So my question is, if you couldn't coexist with a woman like that, just because of the difference in what each of you make?
Not because what she make, is because her time wouldn't afford it. You know the kind of men that those women end up with? Men that's under them.
Come on.
Because they don't, I'm telling you, this is what I know. A man, a real statue and value, don't have time for a woman that's as busy as him, because there's going to be no time to spend with her. This is what I'm talking about, emotions, right? See, what happens, women, not all women, obviously, Queen hasn't displayed any of that, like, have accountability issues. A lot of women, right? A lot of women haven't really been involved with, like, a real masculine. I'm a real masculine dude, right? I'm not going to conform or change or say something away because a woman's going to say, oh, you're attacking me. Well, so damn what? I don't apologize for being masculine. It's how I speak. When I speak, I speak passionately, right? So like you can get, no, I speak, I put passion in my words when I'm explaining things, right? That doesn't mean I'm not angry, I'm not feeling angry. The only thing I was trying to get them to do is say, she's not answering the question. She said something, you say she's giving her opinion, but I asked her a question. Then they're saying you're going from the topic. No, I'm not. So some of the mistakes that was made that her husband made, if he's a high value man, is that he moved her into the house without some form of agreement, some written agreement or something that says, if I want you to leave, because see, and this is why I told her they should both sit down and come to an agreement about what's going to transpire in that relationship. They didn't do that. So that relationship was destined for problems from the inception, right? Because she was supposed to sit down. He was supposed, well, you're going to do this, you're going to do this. He was supposed to tell you, if you move in, you're going to pay half of the bills. Caught her by surprise. She didn't do that. So now people start plotting in the background. She's blaming him, but can she really? Because it was never discussed. And so when he told her, she's like, you know, feelings get involved and all of that and so on and so forth. Okay, but still yet, you consented because you stayed there after he told you. You see what I'm saying? So now you can't come back and complain about it because he told you you was going to pay half. If that was a deal breaker, she was supposed to walk. Then what happened to Ephraim, man? She was supposed to walk away then, right? But she didn't.
Feel what I'm saying? And cover the letter,
sorry. Sabrina. Oh, Sabrina. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, Lisa bought her little hand.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. She checked out. When soon as I started disagreeing with her, she checked out.
Yeah, she said it sounds like it's a Trump rally. I said,
that right there was taking shots, but I took it as a compliment. You see what I'm saying?
I took it as a compliment. I guess she wasn't lying.
I have a weird sense of humor like that. See, here's the thing. A man can't really be affected by the things that women say to him. Because that's just what you call a shit test, right? Women give you these little shit tests, and if you get all emotionally in tuned into it, then they're taking you off your focus, right? So my only point was, can I get you to answer the question? And they didn't like that I just consistently stayed on that. But no, let her talk. Even you said that. I'm letting her talk, Lisa, but I want her to answer the question. Yeah. That, I mean.
Well, it was very good views tonight, and all the men were good in terms of their feedback. What?
But they left. They left. That kind of screwed things up, because see, if people could just set their emotions aside and really listen with the emotions attached, then you could learn something. Because what I'm trying to do is to get them to hear the woman's perspective and then the man's perspective, right? And then trying to come to some sort of, okay, well, I see. But they won't do that. Because now you're being attacked. No, you're not being attacked. Well, your critical thinking, like Queen is saying, was off. I'm just asking questions. So how am I attacking you? That's what would be great. What would be great is for women to start keeping their words. Because you know who's leaving the marriage, Lisa? 75% of the time is the woman. You can't dispute that. And so this is what I know. People don't leave things unless they know they're going to get some value from leaving. She manifests that tonight. She tried to leave. When she say things was going to be more difficult, she came back. If she had left and she saw that things would have been better, she wouldn't have been back with him. She wouldn't be with him right now.
That's the one that said something about 3,000, right? They wanted to pay 3,000. She was like, oh no. I might as well stick around if I got to come up with this 3,000 myself.
When I started exposing that, that's when Sabrina wanted to leave. As long as I was in agreement with her, she was happy go lucky.
He should be giving her an allowance. Like, the bills should be paid and she has her own allowance. Like, I don't understand when you look at, like, the men in Dubai and these different places, these women are well taken care of.
Okay, stop. They're stop right there.
Look at how the women are.
Whoa. Here's a problem. Let me tell you what the problem is. With you, Alisa.
Lisa.
Okay, Lisa. This is the problem with you and a lot of these other women. You want traditional values, but you don't want to be a traditional woman. Those women in Dubai are virgins. Okay. They've only been with one man. If a man gets married over there and he finds out that that woman's hymen's broken, the marriage
they're
is
gonna poor, kill her.
And she gets nothing. No, the marriage is off. She gets nothing.
Okay. Because
that was a fictitious marriage. You know what I found out they was doing now? A lot of the women leave from over there. They have sex with a man. They leave from over there. They go to Europe. They get their hymen stitched back on. Then they go back over there and act like they was a virgin.
That's painful.
You really got women doing that now.
Oh, wow.
You doubt what you said? Google it and look it up.
How would he tell the difference? Would he know?
They don't know, because many of these women are doing it and the men stinking their virgins because a hymen was stitched back on.
Ooh.
Oh my goodness.
That's a lot of work.
You can look it up for yourself. They're doing it.
You know the obedience that them women in Dubai and all that got? Like, to be
but I know one that I shared in a post, and I'm telling you, the amount of, she said her allowance for manicures and pedicures, her allowance for childcare, she's in a pink G-Wagon, she has the amount of money that comes from real estate alone, and this is all from her husband, she has two kids. Yes, they are obedient and maybe they are a virgin, but when you look at the tremendous gap or difference, you can afford to be obedient. That's usually not the case with all of us.
Lisa, many of them still aren't once they get here. I had a lot of friends. I had a lot of friends that was Muslims before I left New York. And a lot of those guys was telling me, once their wife got here,
very
the hijab
true.
Came off, she filed for a divorce.
Very true.
And you know, you see a lot of them, they wear pants. The only thing that's covered now is their head.
That is very true.
But in so many words, she's saying that, like, you making it like the only way you gonna be obedient to a man is if you in a pink G-Wagon.
Oh, no. I'm not saying that, but I'm saying that the far difference of what a man is, like, telling you to do and be for all, like, but it's over, and we're talking about the house and the deed of a house. I could see if it's the deed to an island or a 50-foot building or something, but it's like a house. You gotta live somewhere. And why would a man that you share like 10 years, 15 years, 20 years with someone, maybe you even had a kid or two in a house, you gonna even, I would be like, listen, keep the damn house. You don't even have to, like, we wouldn't have to argue over that. Like, I'd be like, listen, that's my woman. We had a kid, whatever. She could keep the house. I'm giving it to her. A matter of fact, she could keep the house, the car, and whatever. She has my kids, or that was my wife.
Okay,
I wouldn't
so
be
first of all,
arguing
of all,
over no damn house.
But first of all, and that kind of marriage, the children are going to go to the man.
Wherever they go,
the woman doesn't take the children. So why would she need the house if the children? Why would she need the house if the children are going to the man?
But see, that's thinking small.
No, it's not. It's
she
thinking,
still was with her for 10 or 15 years.
She was with the man.
It didn't
so,
work out.
Again, so it goes back to value. All right. Okay, so you're saying, based on what you're telling me, the woman brought value to that relationship? How that you feel that she deserved his house and he's supposed to get out? So what did she bring that he didn't bring? What did she bring to that relationship that he didn't bring or he didn't have without her being there, that she deserved that house?
I don't know. Sometimes mostly the children end up going with the women.
That's but only in some cases. You're using two different scenarios. They can go to the man. You was talking about over
what,
there,
what
right?
What I'm saying is, like, the small things, don't sweat the small stuff. It's like, we got to all live somewhere.
No, you
so I'm just saying, if you have a
now,
house.
I'm trying to address what you were saying, and now you're starting to do what she was doing. Because you're saying that you're saying that she should get the house. So now when I ask you, what did she bring to the relationship? Because let's face it, I'm not your typical Joe. Women like sex just as much as men. Women, she has needs like the man has needs, right? So you're coming to a relationship. So it should be on a... women are quick to scream 50-50, right? But, okay, so the man should say, I need to know what you're bringing to me, a value. Because if it's just box, he could get that anywhere. A man of status is not going to have problems getting boxed. So what exactly is she bringing that she should leave there? Well, it's just a house. Well, if it's just a house, then go out and get one. You don't need the man to get it, right? It's just a house. It's only a house. So go and get your house and bring your house there. And that way,
yeah, but if you were with that man for 10 or 15 years and you didn't
and the man
want
was
that
with
woman
her for 10
working.
15 years. And the man was with her for 10 or 15 years. And now what?
But if you didn't want her working and she was in the house, why would you say, I want the house?
Why would she be breaking up with a man if she was
right
like that for 15 years?
They grew
and then
apart.
All of a sudden, like
okay,
what would be the reason that they
go on her merry way? Then she okay. goes on her merry way. Because there's no such thing as growing apart. Love is something that has to be worked at, right? When people are together for a long time, you will reach a point that you feel like you may not be in love anymore, right? Because they don't do what's necessary to keep that newness, if you will, flowing. And so what does a woman do? Oh, I just got bored. And she leaves the relationship. It's not men that's leaving the relationships. It's women. So if she's going to leave the relationship, she leaves what she came in with, the clothes on her back.
Ain't that a scripture, if I'm not mistaken?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.